faithful. God is faithful. I know he is to perform. God's gonna do it, perform his word. Faithful. God is faithful. I know he is to perform. God's gonna do it, perform his word. God is bigger than my mountain. He's bigger than my valley. Bigger than my problem. He's bigger than my pain. Our God. God is faithful. God is bigger than my mountain. He's bigger than my valley. He's bigger than my problem. He's bigger than my pain. Our God. God is faithful. Faithful. God is faithful. I know he is to perform. God's gonna do it, perform his word. Faithful. God is faithful. I know he is to perform. God's gonna do it, perform his word. Yes, God is bigger than my mountain. He's bigger than my valley. He's bigger than my problem. He's bigger than my pain. Our God. God is faithful. God is bigger than my mountain. He's bigger than my valley. Bigger than my problem. He's bigger than my pain. Our God. God is faithful. Our God. God is faithful. Our God. God is faithful.
Well, praise the Lord. Welcome, welcome, welcome to another Friday. Happy Friday, everybody. Welcome to the Songs of Praise with Stan podcast. Excuse me, my eyes are just giving me a fit. I can't believe it. Get started and they just want to burn. Oh, my goodness. I apologize for that. Forgive me, please. But it's good to have you here today. Glad you're with us. Hope you had a wonderful Thanksgiving with your family. And just pray that everything is going well for you. And I can't believe we have officially entered into the Christmas season, shopping and everything. I'm telling you, churches are going to start having their Christmas programs. And if you go to the mall or to the big box stores, your kids may want to go sit in Santa's lap. Or, you know, kids are already saying, I want this, I want that. And, you know, it's just part of the Christmas season. I know the hustle and bustle. But let's not forget the true reason for this season, and that being the birth of the best gift ever for us, that being Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Got just a couple of quick things I want to share with you. I hope you enjoyed the 7 days of praise. I had a good time putting those together. And we may just make that an annual event to celebrate our anniversary. But it was a fun time. I know that. Had a good time singing some of those songs and just sharing a little scripture with you every day, just taking a brief time to celebrate what God's done here at Songs of Praise. And I just want to share with you some channel statistics. I didn't get a chance to do that on any of those nights. But real quick, just so you know, once again, our first video was put out or uploaded, whatever you'll call it, on November 22nd of 2022. And it was a song video, what even you call it, me singing on TV. Those were put out in the very beginning. We currently have 85 subscribers. You know, it's growing little by little. I'm not concerned about that. I'd like to see it grow. And if you're not a subscriber and you watch us regularly, would you please hit that subscribe button? It would help us out. And hit that bell notification. You'll know when the next video is uploaded or if we happen to go live, which we have done that a couple times. We have uploaded to our channel, whether it be recorded and uploaded later or maybe live stream or just little short videos, whatever. We have got a total of 93 videos we have done in 2 years, and not quite one a week, but that, you remember in the beginning we were putting out a video about once every week or so on that, and then we did our podcast for about every week and a half before we actually started going weekly. We didn't go start going weekly with our podcast till the first of this year. So that kind of puts you, if you're fairly new to the channel, that kind of puts that perspective for you. But those 93 videos, it breaks down to 15 song videos, which were the beginning, and 72 podcasts, and then just, I call them miscellaneous videos, 7 of those where we did live stream or just little short videos to make an announcement. Maybe we're running late. Maybe we didn't get to have a podcast. We didn't get to during Hurricane Helene. There was some time I was sick. We didn't do one. I got on there and said, hey, I'm sorry, just running behind. You know, but 7 miscellaneous videos. Our most popular video, of course, was our very first one. It's gotten the most views in 2 years, 481 views, and that's the song This Blood. And I will try to remember to upload, or not upload, but I'll try to put the link to that down in the description. So if you're new to the channel, have not looked at all videos, you can go back and see our first video. And I hope you will enjoy that. Just, you know, reminisce a little bit. But thank you so much for making it possible. You have made this possible, folks. It's not me, but you've made it possible by doing what you're doing, watching the videos and liking, sharing the videos, subscribing if you haven't done so, and then you know, just taking that time. I know it's a little, you know, we try to keep them under 30 minutes, and we've done pretty good so far. We go over just a little bit here and there, but some of you are faithful to comment below, and we thank you for doing that. Means a whole lot to us. You know who you are. If I try to start naming names, I'm going to forget somebody, but you know who you are. And but just real quick, just want to show you, and I'm the only one here doing this. There's nobody behind that camera there. It's just me. And so I want to just show you this real quick here. There's our email address, songsofpraisewithstan@gmail.com. We'd love to hear from you. Please shoot us an email if you have a prayer request, praise report, maybe just a quick hello. You can do that, or you can comment below, and we'll be sure to get it that way as well. But we'd love to hear from you, and just know where you're watching from. Praise the Lord. Also, probably won't do it quite as much as we're getting more into this. But our scripture that I like to give, our theme scripture, I guess you say, for Songs of Praise is Psalm chapter 40, verse 3. He put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. And that's our theme scripture. And again, that's Psalm chapter 40, verse 3, this New American Standard Version. And I'm telling you, pardon me here, I got to get some water. My throat wants to close up on me. Past few weeks, I've battled bronchitis and then moved down from here up to here, and it's just a mess. And then the change of weather going on and a lot of sickness going around. But got another song I want to sing for you. And I haven't sung this in a while. I need my words for it just to make sure. So you may see me look down. Put them right there. I think I can see them good. But want to sing this for you. Then we're going to look at our scripture. If you want to take your Bible, we're going to be looking at the second half of Psalm chapter 31. Before we had our 7 days of praise, our last regular podcast, we were reading in the book of, we're still in the book of Psalm. We were reading the first half of chapter 31. We're going to do the second half of that today, starting at verse 14. But let's sing this song right here together. If you know it, you can sing it with me, and then we'll get into our scripture reading.
Greatly blessed, highly favored, imperfect but forgiven child of God. Greatly blessed, highly favored, imperfect but forgiven child of God. Greatly blessed, highly favored, imperfect but forgiven child of God. Greatly blessed, highly favored, imperfect but forgiven child of God. Standing upright on God's good earth, counting my blessings, great things He has done. Fighting the good fight with a blessed assurance that the battle is already won. Greatly blessed, highly favored, imperfect but forgiven child of God. Greatly blessed, highly favored, imperfect but forgiven child of God.
Sing it with me now.
Greatly blessed, highly favored, imperfect but forgiven child of God. Oh, greatly blessed, highly favored, imperfect but forgiven child of God. Child of God, I'm a child of God.
Well, praise the Lord. I had to clear my throat there. My apologies. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. It just wants to linger around just enough to where it messes my throat up, don't you know? Praise the Lord. Let's look to our scripture today. If you have your Bibles, take them, turn to Psalm chapter 31. We're going to start reading at verse 14. The subtitle on this is, My Times Are in Thy Hand. If you'll recall, first half of that was deliverance to the distressed. And but we're gonna start reading at verse 14, chapter 31, book of Psalms. Praise the Lord. And I am reading King James Version, okay? But I trusted in thee, O Lord. I said, Thou art my God. My times are in thy hand. Deliver me from the hand of mine enemies, and from them that persecute me. Verse 16, Make thy face to shine upon thy servant. Save me for thy mercy's sake. Let me not be ashamed, O Lord, for I have called upon thee. Let the wicked be ashamed, and let them be silent in the grave. Let the lying lips be put to silence, which speak grievous things proudly and contemptuously against the righteous. Verse 19, oh, how great is thy goodness, which thou hast laid up for them that fear thee, which thou hast wrought for them that trust in thee before the sons of men. Verse 20, thou shalt hide them in the secret of thy presence from the pride of man. Thou shalt keep them secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongues. Verse 21, blessed be the Lord, for he hath shown me his marvelous kindness in a strong city. My apologies, I'm sorry. Verse 22, I've got a split page here. For I said in my haste, I am cut off from before thine eyes. Nevertheless, thou heardest the voice of my supplications when I cried unto thee. Verse 23, O love the Lord, all ye his saints. For the Lord preserveth the faithful and plentifully rewardeth the proud doer. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart, all ye that hope in the Lord. Again, that's Psalm chapter 31, verses 14 through 24. Once again, my apologies, please. Praise the Lord. Friend, I don't know what you're going through today. Maybe it's just been a tough season here. Maybe you've had a loved one that's gone home to be with the Lord. I know several people that's happened to this year. And this is your first holiday season without that loved one, whether it be a husband or father or a grandfather or grandmother or a wife, maybe a son or daughter. All you have to do is just reach out. Let the Lord just love on you. Wrap his loving arms around you and comfort you. He's the only one that can do it during this time, friend. But I speak peace to you if that's you today and you're going through that. Maybe you're battling in your mind because of something like that. Or maybe something that's happened at work and it's just racing through your mind. I just speak the blessings of the Lord and peace upon you today. We're going to be going to the Lord in prayer in just a bit. We'll pray for you. I got one more song I want to sing. If you don't know the Lord and have him in your heart as Lord and Savior, I beg you, would you make that choice today? It's a free gift, salvation. All you have to do is just say something, a simple prayer along the lines of, Dear Jesus, I know you're the Son of God and that you died for my sins and rose again on the third day, conquering death, hell, and the grave. Jesus, I'm a sinner. Please forgive me. Come into my heart, save me, be Lord of my life, and reign in my life forever. Friend, it's just something that simple. If you'll do that meaning with your heart, he'll come in and he'll be Lord of your life. Then you got to remember, you got to get into the Bible, study this book front cover to back cover, find you good. I like to tell people maybe get in the book of John. That's a good book to start with. But get in the book of John, find you a church to be a part of. It doesn't matter the denomination. You've heard me say that time and time again. Our pastor says it here. Denominations are man-made. So you find a church that you feel comfortable and feel at home in. You know, the Lord can use you there. It's important to be in a church body and have that fellowship with like-minded believers. So you got to do that. And I think it kind of helps you hold yourself accountable when you have Christian friends and brothers and sisters that you can go to the Lord in prayer when you have a need too. So that helps with that. Praise the Lord. But we're going to go to the Lord in prayer here very shortly. Got one more song, and then we're going to pray and get out of here. But let's do this song here. If I can remember how it goes, my mind is drawing a blank. But once I hear it, I know I'll know it. As I kneel in the darkness, in the middle of the night, I'm praying for assurance, everything's gonna be all right. Lord, I see another valley out in front of me. I'm afraid I won't be able, and I'll go down in defeat.
And the Lord said, do you remember where I brought you from? Take a look behind you at how far you've come. And every time you ask me, didn't I deliver you? So why would you be thinking that I wouldn't see you through? Didn't I walk on the water? Didn't I calm the raging seas? I spoke to the wind, it hushed and I gave you peace. Didn't I run to your rescue? Didn't I hear you when you called? I walked right beside you just so you wouldn't fall. Didn't I leave all of heaven just to die for your sin? I searched until I found you, and I'd do it all again. Now she's talking to her father in a house that was once a home. She said, these bills, they're coming to you, Lord. And 6 days is not that long. She hears a voice so still and low, said, I've moved like that before. I'll do this little thing for you, but I'll give you so much more. Didn't I walk on the water? Didn't I calm the raging seas? I spoke to the wind, it hushed and I gave you peace. Didn't I run to your rescue? Didn't I hear you when you called? I walked right beside you just so you wouldn't fall. Didn't I leave all of heaven just to die for your sin? I searched until I found you, and I'd do it all again. Didn't I leave all of heaven just to die for your sin? I searched until I found you, and I do it all again.
Praise the Lord. Let's go to the Lord in prayer if we can. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you for another opportunity that you've given us, Lord, to be here in this setting and in this avenue on YouTube, Lord, and be able to sing and praise your holy name, Father, and Lord, share scripture. God, I know to those that are watching, whether they're seeing this as it comes out or down the road a week or two, month or two, a year or two, however long, God, but Father, you know each need and you know each heart, Lord, of those that are watching even at this moment. God, I ask you to reach your loving hand down and touch the one who's just having a tough time, Lord. Lord, I speak peace to them in the name of Jesus. God, to the one that's sick in the sound of my voice, God, I ask you that you would touch them from the top of their head to the soles of their feet. Minister to them in a mighty way. Break this sickness in the name of Jesus. Lord, to the one that may have asked you to come into their heart, Lord, just reveal yourself to him or her right now. Lord, make yourself real to them, Lord. God, I thank you once again for this time together. Lord, we don't want to take it for granted. We never do. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for everything that you've done for us. Now we ask you that you bring us back at the next appointed time when once again we'll sing unto you, Lord, and read your scripture that you gave us. And Lord, we'll be sure to give you praise, honor, and glory in everything that's said and done. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray, and everybody says, amen. Amen. God bless you so much for being with us today. Hope that you'll join us next time when we get together again next week for Songs of Praise with Stan. God bless you.